In this video, I show you how to hold or freeze a frame of your video in Shotcut. Hi everyone, my name is Joe and welcome to Ubitronics. On this channel, I show you how to use open source software. Today, we're looking at holding or freezing a frame of your video in Shotcut. So to start off with, I have created a new Shotcut project and then dragged in a new video clip into the playlist. I'm now going to drag that playlist clip into the timeline. And just to keep it tidy, I'm making sure it's at the very start of the timeline. And to me, the concept of freezing a frame is so that you can demonstrate something or possibly zoom in or do something funky with the still shot that you're using in your video. So generally, when you're doing that, you're going to want to detach the sound from the video so then the sound doesn't get choppy and cut up as well. So the first thing to do is to right click, more, detach audio. This will now mean that you can work with your audio separately from your video clip. Once you've done that, play the video and find the place where you want to freeze the frame. I'm going to imagine my frame is here and I want to freeze this frame for about 4 seconds. The very first thing I'm going to do is come up to File, click on Export Frame, and then save my frame into the location that I want to keep it. I suggest having this in the folder where you've saved your main project files. Once you've done that, navigate to your project folder or wherever you have saved your image and now drag that image into Shotcut's playlist. Now go back to your video and cut at the right place. So make sure you haven't moved the timeline at all and then click on snip. Now you can move the remaining part of your video over and put in your image. If you find yourself with yellow space around each bit, you can right click and remove, and that will push it up. Now, when you play, and I've muted the sound just for now, but now when you play, it will freeze the frame and it will freeze for the amount of time that you want it to freeze. You can extend or shorten this, and then it will carry on playing afterwards. And you may find that you need to handle your audio in a similar way, so you can go to the beginning of where the freeze frame is, cut on the audio track, and now you can move your audio to the correct place or work with it separately if you needed to do something different. Now that the freeze frame is in, you can also add other video tracks on top. So if you wanted to have more effects, then there's nothing stopping you from doing that. You could also use this with keyframes to zoom in or to highlight a certain area, etc. So really, the options are completely up to you. I hope that's been helpful. Please consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.